Hey, what's up, people? I'm here at Roosevelt High School, Street Gospel, first episode. Stay tuned. All right, we're here at the end of the game. Roosevelt just won by how many points?
One.
1 point. It was down to the line. All right, so what's your name?
Curtis Nelson.
Curtis Nelson. How do you feel about that game?
Oh, it was great. It was great. It was a great game.
Okay.
It was a thriller.
It was a thriller?
Yeah.
All right, who's the best NBA player of all time in your opinion?
Michael Jordan.
Michael Jordan? Why?
Because he was the greatest of all time.
Period.
Michael Jordan. NBA player.
Michael Jordan.
Why?
That Scott dunk.
Jason, who is the best NBA player right now?
Derrick Rose.
Who's the best NBA player of all time?
Michael Jordan.
Okay. Who is the best NBA player right now?
LeBron James.
Why is LeBron James the best NBA player right now?
Because he's an all-around player. He's the best player.
Who, in your opinion, who's the best NBA player of all time?
Kobe Bryant.
Kobe Bryant? Why you say Kobe?
He the best.
Just because he the best?
Nah, yeah, he the best.
In your opinion, who's the best NBA player right now?
Right now, I say Kyrie Irving.
Kyrie Irving? Coach Buck, who's, in your opinion, who's the best NBA player of this generation?
I got to go with Durant. I'm not no LeBron man. I got to go with Durant.
Kevin Durant. Kevin, how much money do you think Michael Jordan made over his career?
$300 million, $400 million.
And still making, how much money do you think he making, like, monthly now?
Can't even count.
Okay.
Some shoes.
Yeah, getting them J's. How much money, in your opinion, how much money does it take to buy happiness?
No.
No, why not?
Money can't buy everything. To me.
How can you get happiness then?
I don't know.
You don't know?
It's plenty of ways, you know. You just gotta pray and, you know, it's a lot.
How much money does it take to buy happiness?
Can't buy happiness.
How do you get happiness?
Just be happy.
Just be happy?
Just be happy. Trust in God and be happy.
How much money does it take to buy happiness?
You can't pay for happiness.
Why not?
You just can't. Like, I don't know. I can't really explain it.
Okay, how do people become happy?
Being with their family, doing what they want to.
Okay. It's
free spirit.
Free spirit?
Yeah.
How much money does it take to buy happiness?
None.
Why?
Happiness don't. It just don't. Money don't take the buy happiness.
How do you get happy?
Family.
Friends.
Real friends.
Okay. How much money does it take to buy happiness?
None. Don't take no money to buy no happiness.
It doesn't take money to buy happiness. How do you get happiness?
By being happy, by doing things. I don't know.
How much money do you think it takes to buy happiness?
Happiness.
Yeah. How much money do you think? How much money do you think it takes to buy happiness?
You can't buy happiness.
You can't buy happiness. How much money does it take to buy happiness?
For me, it don't take much.
Don't take much.
Dollar menu. I'm a dollar menu man.
Okay. Coach Buck, do you have any spiritual beliefs?
Yes. I believe in God. He's the reason for the season. He's the reason why we woke up this morning. And all the above.
You have any spiritual beliefs?
Like, I believe in God.
Okay. To you, who is Jesus Christ?
Jesus. He is, like, the man that stuck up us.
The man that did what?
Stuck up us.
Do you have any spiritual beliefs?
Nah.
To you, who is Jesus Christ?
Yeah. No, I do believe in Jesus. I believe that he died for my sins.
Do you have any spiritual beliefs? To you, who is Jesus Christ?
He's a man.
Okay. Do you have any spiritual beliefs?
Yeah.
What's your spiritual belief?
Christianity.
Yeah. To you, who is Jesus Christ?
My father.
He your father?
Somebody who made me.
Somebody who made you? So what's your spiritual belief?
What's my spiritual belief?
Yeah, you said trust in God, right?
God is the greatest.
God is the greatest?
Yeah.
To you, who is Jesus Christ?
Who is Jesus Christ?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ can be you. It can be me.
Okay.
We are his temple.
Okay.
So we are the ones that carry this on for God.
A lot of happiness to come
you
your way.
You said pray? Yeah. So what's your spiritual belief?
You said pray.
Yeah, I'm Baptist. You know, I believe in God a lot.
You believe in God a lot? Yeah. To you, who is Jesus Christ?
You put me on blast.
You say you're a Baptist?
You know, Jesus, he could be, to me, he could be a man, woman, you know. He God, anything possible. He anybody to me.
Do you believe in heaven and hell? If you were to die today, where would you go? Why?
Because, like, I do everything that God wants me to do.
You do everything that God wants you to do?
Yes.
If what you were believing was wrong, would you want to know?
Yes.
Do you believe in heaven and hell?
Yes.
If you were to die today, where would you go?
I think I'd go to heaven.
Why?
Because I believe in Jesus Christ, and, you know, I pray. You know. But I just don't believe some stuff that the Bible say, though.
Okay, if what you were believing was wrong, would you want to know?
Yeah.
Do you believe in heaven or hell?
Yeah.
If you were to die tonight, where would you go?
To heaven.
Why?
I mean, if I get to pray real, I don't know.
If what you were believing was not true, would you want to know?
Yeah, I want to know.
Do you believe in heaven or hell? If you were to die tonight, where would you go?
Probably, since I ain't saved, probably hell.
Does that concern you?
Yeah, it concerns me.
Do you believe in heaven or hell?
Heaven and hell is here on earth.
Okay, if you die tonight, where would you go?
Well, if there is a heaven, I'm going. Because I do all the right things.
But you do all the right things?
Yes, I do all the right things.
If what you was believing was not true, would you want to know?
Beg pardon, say that again.
If what you believe wasn't true, would you want to know?
Oh, yes.
Do you believe in heaven or hell?
Yeah.
If you was to die tonight, where would you go?
I have no clue, but honestly, probably hell.
Why you say that?
Because I'm a big sinner. I know I am.
Okay, if you what you believe was wrong, would you want to know?
Yeah.
Take these cards. Now, I'm going to give you the mic and read number one out loud.
For all have sinned and fall short of glory of God.
What does that mean to you?
It's like if you sin. Dang, I don't know.
Yeah, all it means is we all done did bad stuff. We all guilty of sin. What does that mean to you?
For all of that sin, he gonna forgive us for what we have done or something?
Nah, that means we all have done wrong, we all have sinned, and we all fall short of glory of God, because when we sin, we fall short of God's glory. What does that mean to you?
Whoever was doing bad stuff, fall short of God.
Okay, so we all have done wrong stuff, right? And when we sin, we fall short of God's glory. Like, we fall short of his expectations for us, right? What does that mean to you?
Everybody that sinned before in their life.
Okay. What does that mean to you?
We all have sinned. There's no perfect person out here.
Okay.
If there's a perfect person out here, it's only God.
Okay. What does that mean to you?
For all the sin, all you got to do is come back to God and ask him for the cleanliness of your soul, and he'll do it.
So all I see, we all done bad stuff, and we fall short of God's standard. But read number two.
For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Jesus Christ our Lord.
What does that mean to you?
I can't even explain it.
Okay, because we sin, we deserve death. We all gonna die, right? 100% of us gonna die. But the gift of God is eternal life through Christ Jesus. So God's giving us a free gift if we choose to accept it through Christ Jesus. Eternal life, we can live forever. What does that mean to you?
Like, it's like when you sin, like, you're doing bad things, but eternal life is like when you do good things for God and Jesus Christ.
What that really means is that the wages of sin, because we have broken God's law, we deserve to die. But God's gift is eternal life that we get to live forever through Jesus Christ. What does that mean to you?
That he's giving us eternal life if we believe in him. Stuff like that, yeah.
Okay, that's pretty much it. For the wages of sin is death. Like we said, sin causes death, but the gift of God's gift is eternal life through Christ Jesus, right?
Yeah.
What does that mean to you?
I don't know.
All right, that means that because we sin, we deserve death, but God gives us a free gift through Jesus Christ our Lord. What does that mean to you?
That means once you put yourself into the Lord's hand, your life is eternal.
Okay.
Forever.
Okay.
The wages of sin is death. The more sin you do, you're going to die early. But it's eternal life if you come to God and ask for forgiveness.
Yeah, pretty much. Because we sin, we deserve death, but God's giving us a free pass, eternal life. I read card number three. It's only four cards.
All right, but God demonstrated His own love towards us, and that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us.
What does that mean to you?
Even though we were still bad, He still died for us.
He still paid that price for us, even though we were still sinning, right? What does that mean to you?
Like, even though like He died for us, because it's like He died. Because He didn't believe that we should be getting treated the way they was treating us.
Okay, so that means while we're still breaking God's law, Christ came and died for us. All right, read number four. What does that mean to you?
Like, He still died knowing that we're sinners and that we can, repent and stuff like that.
What does that mean to you?
Like, even though we doing all the stuff we doing, God still loves us and He died for us.
All right, what does that mean to you?
That means that He put His life on the line for us.
Okay.
You know, uh-huh. He died for us. He died for our sins.
Uh-huh.
Therefore, we should respect that and try and go on and live the life. We're not going to be perfect,
uh-huh.
But we can be perfect in those areas that we practice on being perfect in.
Okay. What does that mean to you?
Right now.
We was all still sinning. Like, you know, we were still sinners. And Christ came and died for us while we didn't do nothing to deserve it, but we were still doing our own thing, and Christ came and died for us while we still acting wild in the club, smoking, killing, drinking. And read the last one, number four.
That if you confess with your mouth and your Lord Jesus Christ believes in your heart and God has raised Him from the dead, you will be saved.
What does that mean to you?
I mean that when He raised from the dead, if you believe in Him, you'll go to heaven.
Okay.
Yeah, that he died, that you believe that He died and all that, and raised again, so.
What does that mean to you?
It means that, it said that God was raised from the dead, like, we would be saved.
Okay, that means that you say, confess with your mouth, Jesus Lord, like, Lord, I know, Jesus, I know you're Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you shall be saved. So that's the way you be saved, salvation. What does that mean to you? All right, if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, you're like, Lord, I believe, Jesus, I believe you, and you believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you shall be saved. There you go, right there. So what does that mean to you?
It means if I get my life straight, then I'm gonna be going to heaven.
Nope, that means if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart God raised Him from the dead, you're gonna be saved. It's not about getting your life together, because Christ is gonna get your life together for you. What does that mean to you?
Okay, it means that if you believe in God, that He died for you,
mm-hmm.
and that He came back, you will be delivered. Once you die, you shall go to His place.
What does that mean to you?
If you ask God to forgive you all your sins, He a forgiving God, a loving God. He always forgive you. There's nothing He won't forgive you about.
Okay. If you confess with your mouth, that means, Lord, say it out loud, and then believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you shall be saved. Would it be any reason you wouldn't want to accept Jesus Christ right now in your heart and then be sure that when you die, you get to be before God? And not only when you die, right here on earth, you can fulfill your purpose on earth. Would you like to do that?
Yeah.
Would you like to accept Christ into your heart? And then you would like to do that? Is there any reason you wouldn't want to accept Jesus in your heart right now and be sure that when you die, you get to meet Him in heaven, be cool with Him? Have you did that already?
Yeah.
When did you do that?
Seven? Yeah.
So would it be any reason you wouldn't want to do that right now and be sure that when you die, you get to stand before God and be cool with God, but not only when you die, you get to, right here on earth, fulfill your purpose on earth. Would you like to do that today?
Yeah.
Would you like to accept Christ right now and be sure that when you die, you get to stand before God and be cool with God, but not only when you die, right here on earth, you get to fulfill your purpose on earth? Would you like to do that?
Yeah.
In your heart, since you've been here, have you actually done those things?
Yes.
Okay, what year did you get saved?
1984.
Okay. Would it be any reason you wouldn't want to do that right now and be sure that when you die, you get to stand before God and be cool with God, and not only when you die right here on earth, you can fulfill your purpose right here on earth? Would you want to do that? Would it be any reason you wouldn't want to do that? That's the question.
No, there ain't no reason. You can't never deny God.
What we're going to do is say a prayer, right? and you're going to repeat the prayer. But I can't make you believe in your heart. But if you believe the words that you say in your heart, then you're going to be saved. All right? So repeat after me. Father God, I know I'm a sinner. And I know my sin is wrong. But I know that you love me. And you sent your son down here to die for me. Jesus, I believe that you died on the cross for my sins. But you did not stay dead. You resurrected on the third day. Jesus, come into my heart. Forgive me of all my sins. And wash me and cleanse me of your blood. Thank you for the new life I have in you. Amen. According to the Bible, you just been born again. So now you're sure that when you pass from this life to the next life, whatever, you can stand before God. You don't got to stand before God as he won't be your judge, but he'll be your savior. He'll be your father. So instead of standing before him as, you know, getting condemned, now you're free, right? You're free to do what God called you to do, what he created you to do. I got the book of John. I'm going to give it to you right there. This is the book. It's in the Bible. It tells the story of Jesus or whatever. It's one of the books in the Bible. It's easy. That's the first thing you need to do now that you accepted Christ. And then that's it. Pretty much you have to find a good church home. I go to Embassies of Christ. You ever heard of Embassies of Christ? Of Cleveland. Come check us out, man. Yeah, man. See? Because you've been born again. Your spirit's been reborn or whatever. Yeah, so I'm going to have you fill out this birth certificate real quick. And then I'm going to give you the thing with your baptism date. And then that's it.
Come experience worship. Fellowship. A great level. My faith is on. Outreach. A great level. My faith. And a powerful word.
God doesn't want one person in his kingdom to be poor. David said, I was young and now I'm old, yet I've never seen the righteous forsaken.
Jesus is coming back, and he is going to be at the finish line. And he's going to call on everybody that couldn't be stopped.
Embassies of Christ Kingdom Ministries every Sunday at 9 a.m. and 11:30 a.m. and Wednesdays at 7 p.m. Located at 4285 Cleveland Street here in the new city of faith, Gary, Indiana. Experience the church where miracles happen.